Mike Trom. I'm from Blooming Prairie, Minnesota. Farm and soybeans in Dodge County. Currently running a 16-row 4540 HD. It's a pretty older machine with 8,000 pound bins. I started strip tilling back in 2015, utilizing SoilWarrior's lease program, and purchased this unit in 2016. Our typical tillage practice consisted of fall chisel plow, then hydrous, and then spring field cultivator. That was for corn, soybeans. This corn stalks were disc ripped and then field cultivated twice in the spring. I originally got interested in it. I had a soybeans rather than corn, just for the simple fact that, I mean, my soybean yields had kind of stalled out, and I was just sick of all the passes and burn up all the fuel. That's when I really started investigating it. And I dabbled in it a little bit here and there, had other people try it for me or do some acres for me. And then it was the spring of 14. It wasn't a great spring, kind of wet, and my chisel plow ground, I waited for it to dry out and thought things would fit. We ran the field cultivator out there, and when I went to plant, it was just horrible planting conditions. We had speared the ground underneath, it wouldn't dry out, and I basically at that point just said I'm fed up with that system. There has to be a different way. And that's when that fall I leased the SoilWarrior. Been doing it ever since. It's certainly a well-built machine. It's heavy, rugged design. I've done a lot of research, and some of the other units out there, row units, are a little lighter built. Obviously, if I knew I was going to look at purchasing one, I wanted something that was going to hold up and last. And that's led me towards the SoilWarrior. I'm a numbers person. Pretty much every decision we make on the farm has to have an ROI, or else I don't do it. Switching to the strip till system has saved, just in time, has saved me. How do you put a value on your own time? But several hours an acre that I don't spend out here, doing other operations. So, from a fuel standpoint, we're running along here at about half gallon an acre. Comparing that to a chisel plow, a field cultivator, you're talking, savings of 2 to 3 gallons an acre, $5 diesel. So that's a pretty easy decision to make. And then, from the nutrient standpoint, early on, I wanted to have a baseline comparing it to conventional tillage, so I didn't really mess with my fertility program because I wanted to see, if I could raise as good or better corn with the strip till system. And once I had proved that to myself, then I started messing with, cutting back on rates on fertilizer. So depending on how aggressive you want to get, there's definitely, savings to be had there as well. So I'd say 25%, well, 3/4 of the acres I go aggressive here at custom. At least this year, that's the way it's going to end up shaking out. I guess that was part of the, momentum to make a purchase. I had neighbors that were interested in strip till. They didn't have the time or the bandwidth to take that on themselves, but it's something they wanted to do. It definitely helped with first unit, having those extra acres to spread that cost out every year. Strip till is really starting to gain popularity in this area, in southern Minnesota. And I do talk to people a lot about it. People ask, what we're doing out here and what things are like about it. You know, and I suppose the biggest thing, and it was the same for me when I switched to strip till, is that I was taught, you know, when you go to plant, it has to be flat and black. That was what I was taught. And it turns out that's not the case. You know, and it took a while to get your head wrapped around that. But, you know, it was more of a mental thing than anything. I think that's, you know, for a lot of people, you know, it's just that mental thing of they've always done it like this. You know, we have to till the fields before we plant. That's just not the case. Visually, you know, by the springtime after the freeze-thaw cycle, the berms have kind of settled out. And so, you know, the field looks basically level. You know, you don't see your berm per se anymore. I mean, it's there, but it's not as nearly as high as it was now as they are now. And, you know, it looks a little cloddy, you know, and you're like, wow, I'm gonna plant them this, you know. And the second you put your plant on the ground and go dig up some seed, it's amazing. I mean, it's the best seed bed I've ever planted to behind the strips. I mean, the ground's mellow, there's moisture there, the clods that you see up on the surface, you know, that you think your row units would be bouncing across, they basically just break up and turn to powder. It's a non-issue. So, like, say, visually, it looks something a lot different than it used to, but once you start planting and actually dig up some seed, it's a game changer for me, or it was for me, anyway. There's a lot of lessons learned. One is, you know, familiarize yourself with, you know, how the delivery system works as far as the fertilizer, you know, what things can cause it to not apply fertilizer at the correct rate, you know, leaving a lid open or a loose hose or things like that. And then obviously the different adjustments you can make in certain conditions, but that's, you know, kind of a learning curve. You'd have to spend some time with it to really get that. But knowing the delivery system, how it works, what the fundamentals of that are, how to calibrate. And then I guess, you know, be patient. You know, this is your one shot to do it right ahead of the planter. So, you know, take your time. Don't get in a hurry. And I mean, really, the person making the strips, I always say it should be the guy that is running the planter, but somebody of equal capability. I think you're going to be, especially starting out, you're going to be much happier with the end result. Just because person that plants, they know how headlands should be done, and you know how to attack a field and lay it out so planting goes smoothly. Another thing that helped tremendously for me is before I started strip tilling, I created guidance lines for all my fields around the borders, all the headlands, everything. So I had that all laid out ahead of time, and that's a huge time saver. You're out here making your strips, if you have all your headlands done, I mean, you can just blunt a field and go. And that way, you know, when you come back to plant the next year, you're not guessing, like, oh, is it, you know, X, Y, Z line, or this one. So that's a huge thing, too, for a found that saved me a lot of grief.